Hey guys, how's it going? Well, every year we show a video of everything that we've done, so I hope you guys like this video, and if you guys don't, well, too bad.
Like it came on at midnight. The soul of the season is a let's open up and let's embrace this moment.
Where is Brian?
Lives are like stones, they sink in. Pulling the air you're breathing. You can keep it inside. The devil will reside if you let him. Our hearts are all barricaded.
So how do you get saved? What does it mean to be saved? Oh, okay. I need a group speaker. Where's Mario?
I'm just listening.
Oh, Mario. Okay, Mario, how do you get right with God? Tell me, Mario.
Repenting of your sins.
Repentance of your sins. Very good. And?
Accepting the Lord as your Lord and Savior.
Right. So that's right. You repent from your sins. And that means that you're going to turn away from your sins. So let's say you are addicted to pornography. Okay, you got some dirty magazines, dirty CDs. You go home tonight and you throw them away. And you say, God, I'm going to follow you. I'm believing that Jesus died for every sin I ever committed on that cross. And that he took all of my punishment that I deserve in hell. And that he rose again 3 days later. I'm going to put my faith and trust in Jesus. Not in a church, not in some good works, but in Jesus Christ alone. And I'm going to follow him all the days of my life. So you guys are from a church?
Yeah.
Okay, what church?
Temple Baptist.
Okay, sounds good. Sounds like a good church. Look at the fruit. Is that your youth pastor?
Yeah.
Oh, good job, youth pastor. Are you guys handing out tracts or just going to Casey's? That's okay. God gives us good things to enjoy. There's nothing wrong with it. I don't need it anymore, but yeah. Well, so good. So you guys you understand what it means to be saved.
Yes.
Okay. Well, then let me encourage you guys to continue on, because you're at a young age and you're going to be attacked with all kinds of things.
I did that a couple times.
Less graceful, not so graceful. God,
do it today. Do it again.
You guys are going down.
You guys are going down. You guys are going down. What? What?
Ready?
Wait.
Ready?
Go.
So, oh, I'm waiting.
So after 4 years of being with Itb Youth, we're always depending on a lot of people to take people, pick up people, and Arleith, thanks to my wife, we were able to save up some money and we purchased a van. We named it the Beast because we grabbed it the same day as Josie's birthday. And one day we actually spent all day pretty much cleaning it. And during our some trips, kind of warmed up to its name, the Beast. It actually took some beatings, like a man.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before.
It's kind of like a tradition to always do our retreat, our winter retreat, our snow cabin trip. I think only 1 year we actually had snow, but the rest of the years we didn't have anything. So this is our snow cabin trip video.
When it's coming apart, you had it all.
But first, let me take a selfie.
When it's coming apart, you had it all. It wasn't enough. No, it's not enough. They tell you it's not worth the price, so just let it go. But you know you can't. You know you won't. It's not easy, no, finding the words to say. When you're feeling lost, you'll find your way. The world is so broken, and sometimes it leaves you cold. Like a stone, 'cause when you're afraid, it weighs on your soul. It's It's not easy knowing, finding the words to say when you're feeling lost. You'll find your way. The world is so broken, and sometimes it leaves you cold. And at times you can't feel the fire to guide you home. The demons will haunt you and try to steal what you know. But the angels, they brought you and they're gonna hold you up. They're gonna hold you up. Finding the words to say when you're feeling lost, you'll find your way. The world is so broken, and sometimes it leaves you cold. And at times you can't feel the fire to guide you home. The demons will haunt you and try to steal what you know. But the angels, they brought you and they're gonna hold you up. They're gonna hold you up. They're gonna hold you up. Timing is right, somehow you'll know. When nobody stands, stand on your own.
So as a youth group, we try new things. We try not to stay basic. We like to try new things. And this year we were able to go to an actual play. It wasn't just a normal play. It was a... The Book of Revelations, which it was just a musical, which the Book of Revelations is technically a book of worship. Here is just a small little clip of what we experienced that day, and I think the actors were pretty cool. This video, next coming video, is kind of trippy, but not really. As a youth servant, it's not just about ministering to people or teaching people about the Bible, but it's about being there for them. And sometimes we got to do things that I wouldn't expect, you know. So this year, me and my wife were able to take Matthew and Nicole to prom, which was really cool because me and Ali were able to spend some time together in the OC by ourselves, and we were able to share in Matthew's last dance of school, and you know, it was really cool. And I hope I don't do it this year though.
If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll sail the world to find you. If you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light to guide you. Find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you like 4, 3, 2, and you'll be there. That's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah.
Ooh. All right, this next video is something that we always do. It's something that we always enjoy going to. And it's for the music, for the studies, just to have fellowship with other churches and go out into the field. And so this is our harvest video. The next video is kind of sums up where a lot of men are nowadays. I remember when I wanted to do this this trip, and it required, I only want to do it men. The men told me men. Some of the girls were like, no, you can't be sexist. It's a youth group, not a men's group or a girls group. So I opened it up both for girls and men. And needless to say that it was the women that actually came to this trip more than the men, and all the men that were planning to come didn't even show up. And kind of shows you where we as men are lacking when it comes to, you know, saying something and then not following through. So it's a rebuke to men and also an encouragement to women that they're doing good things, you know, for the Lord. So and even though this wasn't we weren't having a Bible study, we were just exploring something great and doing some dangerous things, and especially that cold water. You'll know what I'm talking about. Oh, the famous tree. Yes.
Is this the subway?
Yeah, almost. We gotta take a picture, guys, we gotta take a picture with the log. Come on.
Huh?
Yeah. 4 hours more to get to the ground. The famous tree, the pictures. This next video is something that I've always wanted to take the youth to. I just never had the capacity to take them, but this time we did, and no one got hurt, no one died, which is primarily the main name of this place, and I hope you guys like this video.
Father, I'm going through some heavy things. It seems like this world ain't getting any better. The more we try to get closer to you, the farther we run from your throne. I spent so many nights wondering, when will it end? When will the day come when happiness begins? I'm running the race, but it seems so hard to win. I'm sick of mourning, my stomach is throwing up in the morning. I'm calling for help and watching it melt away. My heart's been put on display and put away in many ways. Many times I told myself it was okay, and anger was the price that was paid. While these faded dreams just screamed to bring them home, the burden was too heavy, I kept running from the throne. I can't take it anymore. Longer, I can taste my spirit hunger. God, please help me get home.
Lord, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'm not scared, cause you're holding my
breath.
5 days, lack of water resources, no civilization,
Wi-Fi.
Hey,
my only fear that I don't have enough time left to tell the world that there's no time left.
The terms that I'm burning both sides of the rope, and I'm hoping that self-control would kick in before I'm choking.
Bring warm clothes, he said.
I need the Lord in every way. I'll never make it, I'm not going back to the way I was before Christ in my life. I couldn't do it, I would lose it. There's no point to the fight, and I'm writing this song for the people who don't belong. I pray away the pain you feel from all the things that went wrong. Inside a life that's filled with anger and disappointment, cause daddy treated you weaker than all of the other kids. It's annoying, and I feel for all of you who wanna give up. You feel stuck, I feel the same way. Lord, help us stay up. You couldn't pay me to abandon the idea of true hope, that I can make it through this life into a place where there's no crying. I'm dying to find you with open arms when I go, knowing you love me and you waiting to give rest to my soul. Oh,
you know, I started this youth group about 4 years, 4.5 years ago. And one of the things is that I come to realize that it is a youth group, not a church. We are an extension of the church, but not a church. And one of the things that I realized, especially coming this year, is that a lot of the people that I started with are leaving. They are going from high school to college, and it's one of the inevitable things.
It's been another day when it seems like faith eludes me. Everything's been so confusing. Fear got the best of me. Now I'm lying here worried about tomorrow, cause the weight of everything I don't know is so heavy I can't sleep. But the truth remains the same, even when I don't know what to pray. But what I know is you, my God, are real. No matter how I feel, you've never let me go. And what I know is there will never be a day. You aren't just a breath away. And through it all, I've got to hold to what I. I could throw my fist in the air demanding answers, but in spite of all the questions, I'm still giving you my life. And if it doesn't turn out like I think it should, it doesn't change the fact you're always good. Your ways are higher than mine, and the truth remains.